This one over here is important, right? Why is it important? Because most of the time some traders prefer to take one entry types and it has more losses than the other one. And then they will say smart money doesn't work because they are taking these trades, they are taking these entries, right? But let's look at the entry type, right? This is what we call risk entry. It's a sniper entry, right? That's what we call sniper entry. It's called sniper entry. It's simply because it just touches your order blocks and go away. You get what I'm saying? Just touch. It's a tap. Tap, then it moves away, right? That's what we call sniper entry. If you have your limit order there, it will just activate your limit order and then moves away and to take profit, right? That's why it called sniper entry. That's why it called risk entry, right? For example, as you can see over here, we have another block here at the top. Here at the bottom over here, we have some liquidity that the market understand that it has to go back into that area. Some liquidity over here as well. The market needs to understand that the market needs to go back into that area. Some liquidity over here as well, right? So we have traders that entered here, traders here, traders here, but this area here has to come and sweep out everybody in these areas, right? So what's gonna happen? We have liquidity. One, we understand we have a place where we anticipate the market has to go to, right? That's number two. Then when it comes to an entry, then the market needs to tap. But what will happen is the market will just create something like this when it reaches your area, right? Right, create something like this, right? So as you can see over here, right, we have what? We have our stop loss in this area, right? But already we have 3 weeks that basically takes us out from the game. Do you get what I'm saying? That's the power of risk entry. It will always try to take you out of the game. Most of the time it will take you out of the game, right? Why? Because you haven't confirmed the market that it has to go into a different direction, right? You just thought, you know what, since the market, it's going to go into this area, I've analyzed the market, yes, will go into that area. So definitely, while the market will have to create some wicks taking everybody out because there is this level over here that the market has to kiss, right? So it will take everybody out in this game before it continue all the way down, right? So this is what we call risk entry, and it's a risk. It's a risk. It doesn't play. Trust me, it doesn't play. It will take you out and you're gonna cry every day, right? So remember, guys, the moment I created this YouTube channel, right, and the moment I created this course, it wasn't in a purpose of making you win your trades every day. No, I didn't create my YouTube channel to basically help you win every day. No, I created my YouTube channel to actually help you from minimizing your losses when it comes to smart money. That's why I teach all this petty and I teach everything when it comes to my channel. I'm teaching you into a space whereby you have to limit your losses so that your small wins will increase. Do you get what I'm saying? Your small wins will increase. The aim is to limit out, is to filter out all the basic, the unnecessary trades, all the unnecessary patterns, all the unnecessary things that you do when it comes to your charts. Do you get what I'm saying? So this is what is called a confirmed. And why? Because it has to actually come into the space. Sorry about that. It has to actually break out the structure, change the character before you can even consider entering the market. And what's so good about it is that once it breaks out, then you go into a smaller time frame, you find a new entry that has a new stop loss, as you can see over here, that has a new stop loss and entry over here. The take profit is still the same. Do you get what I'm saying? Why? Because you still understand that there is liquidity that is left here. So you have to wait for the market to confirm, right? Confirm. As you can see, we have what is called trend line liquidity, right? Once the market has gave you a touch over here, right, and then the market touched your order block, right, and then break a structure over here, and then what more do you ask for, right? What more do you ask for? Because over here we have what is called your entry, and then pushing all the market down. Do you get what I'm saying? Pushing the market down. That's all basically you need to understand when it comes to confirmed entry. The market needs to come and change the direction first, change of character first, before you can think about entering that trade. Do you get what I'm saying? So it's so important that you have to always by every means, always use the confirmed entry, not the risk entry, the confirmed entry. Do you get what I'm saying? But even if you entered in a confirmed entry, you go into a higher time frame, it will be like you entered in a sniper entry. Do you get what I'm saying? It will be like you entered a sniper entry. So always, by every means, always try to use a confirmed entry. It will limit your losses and increase your wins. But other than that, let's go and look at the charts, actually how the risk entry look like and how the confirmed entry look like. So this is what we call a risk entry, right? So whereby when the market touches your order block, you just decide to enter the market without knowing that the market will still come back. But luckily in this example, if you were that person who basically look at this exactly, selling candle and decide to put your stop loss in the exit line, right, you would have been taken out, because as you can see over here, this wick, right, this wick is just below the order block line, right? So that means it took out some people over here. But if you were so advanced enough into a space whereby you notice that there is a wick that is below this order block, so you would have had to put your stop loss below this wick, because this tells you that the market might come back into this area. Do you get what I'm saying? But other than that, this is what we call a risk entry. One may ask, why do you believe that the market will come back into this area? See, there is simple factor that happened here, right? There is a ranging market that happened in this area, right? As you can see, the market, before it even break out here, the market started consolidating, right? And then push all the way up. What made this market consolidating here? Simple factors, right? There is liquidity, right? In this area, a lot of people try to enter the market here, pushing the market up, right? And what did they do? They left their stop losses over here. Do you get what I'm saying? So the market did what? The market reversed, tried to take up everybody in this area and trying to push the market towards the top. Do you get what I'm saying? So that's what you need to understand. So basically, this is what we call a risk entry. A risk entry, you just come in and you enter the market the way you see it fits. Do you get what I'm saying? Without doing any analysis. But here we have another risk entries, right? So as you can see over here, we have an entry. Here we have an entry. Do you get what I'm saying? Here we have an entry. Okay, here it didn't touch. But here there are two entries, right? Here and here, right? So basically, yeah, this is what happened, because you break over here, we have entries over there. Do you get what I'm saying? So that's what you basically is your risk entry, without even going into a smaller time frame and doing all those things. Do you get what I'm saying? Just seeing an order block and decide, you know what, I'm just going to enter here, pushing the market down. See another order block. Oh, wow, that's nice. I'm just going to enter here, push all the market down. See another order block. Oh, that's nice. I'm just going to push here and push all the market up. Do you get what I'm saying? That's what we call basically a risk entry. But risk entries are risk entries. They are not just saying a risk entries. As you can see over here, we have another order block that I didn't see, and then that will push all the market up. So risk entries, it's risk entry by the name, risk entry. Do you get what I'm saying? It's very, very risky. But when we speak about confirmed entries, do you get what I'm saying? Let me try and get a confirmed entry for you. So as you can see over here, the market, we have an order block there, but we are not in this one. We are in this one, right? So as you can see, we have what is called a change of character, right? So we have what is called an order block in here, right? What do we have here? We have what is called the liquidity, right? Where the market is doing what? Where the market is ranging. Do you get what I'm saying? Push all above. So since we have a ranging market, what does that mean? This means the market will have to come back into our area before the market will push all the way up. You get what I'm saying? So once the market came back, right, in this space over here and touches our order block here, right, the market touches our order block here, cut out everybody who put all their stops and all the other things here, and then have an entry here touches our order block. And then what does that mean? That means now the market is ready to do what? It's ready to rally, right? So once now we have what is called market touching, this is what happens, right? Go into a smaller time frame and find a change of character. As you can see over here, we have what is called a change of character. The market has break above, right? And then the market came back, right? Consolidating, right? Coming back into this area. And once it touches this baby, then the market did what? The market decided to shoot up. So this is what we call basically a confirmed entry. Do you get what I'm saying? Find your order block, right? Find your order block. Market has to come back into your order block. Once it came back into your order block, then you find a change of character. Once you find a change of character, the market touches and push all the way up. Do you get what I'm saying? So basically, that's what is called change of character, actually a confirmed entry, right? But for now, let's just go back into whiteboard and see what we can learn next.